What's up, my people? Basing on the survey made as a follow-up regarding the challenges people face while starting up, I shared with a few. Today, I'm going to share with all of you in this video a few techniques on how you can master selling and how you can sell your products and you yourself as an individual to the people and to customers. I want to let you know, with the right techniques, you can sell anything to anyone at any time. Those of you who think that selling is all about the CEO going to sell his idea of the startup to investors so that he can secure an investment, today I'm here to let you know that you as an individual, if you become very good at selling, you are going to raise your odds above. It's very hard to be rejected if you know how to sell. This is one of the reasons you should watch this video until the end. Big shout outs to Gab Angra and Kristen for the comments on last week's episode. If you didn't check out the video, click on the link above to check out that video. Watch the other episode of last week. I want to let you know, the ability to sell depends on your ability to convert boring facts into captivating scenarios. Usually a customer really wants to know, is there a way I'm missing out something by not buying such a product from this individual? So if you're able to convert such scenarios, such questions into ideas, you will start selling big and big each and every day. So before you start selling, you have to ensure that you build a relationship with the customer. This relationship will bring a connection between you and the customer. It will connect you in one way or the other. I want to let you know that selling is emotion based. So once you twist the emotions of the customer, it's very easy to sell to that customer. Often, I usually see people come to sell to me. Someone comes to you and they go direct to the point. This is not good at all. This is not the first time you're seeing me. But nevertheless, even if it's the first time you're seeing me, without building a relationship, I'll just feel like this person is just trying to use the opportunity to sell to me, but I'm not connected to them. They are trying to force their product or their idea onto me. But if you build a connection, it becomes very easy to sell because the customer feels comfortable doing business with you. So before you start selling to anyone, at least try to build a relationship with the customer. Build a connection, build a foundation with the customer, so that while you're selling to the customer, they feel comfortable doing business with you. So every time a customer stands in front of you, or if you're doing business online and this customer reaches to your inbox to inquire a few things from you, these are the questions they have in their mind. Can I trust this guy? Can I trust this lady? Do they have the best things? Are they trustworthy people? So these questions, they run in the minds of customers. Once a customer reaches up to you, they are having those questions in their mind. Have you ever wondered why customers check on your Facebook, Twitter, Instagram before doing business with you? If you don't know, now you know. Credibility is the answer. Customers usually feel so comfortable. They want to do business with people who are credible. Once you build credibility, it will make the customer trust you, thus making the customer loyal to you. And every time you mistreat a customer, you're missing out on a chain of customers that customer is going to bring to you through recommendations. So you don't want to miss out that. Make sure you build your credibility. You do sell genuine things to customers. You make sure whatever you're doing, there is an element of trust. With that, it will also take you from one level to another in your business and selling game. Always have a sample at hand. Every time you're selling, you have to make sure you have something to show to the customer. Once you're approaching the customer, always ask yourself in your mind, how can I sell to this person without just telling them but showing them? Always have something to show to the client. Show them what you do. If you sell crisps, if you sell daddies, if you sell anything, have it in your bag, have it at hand. If you design apps, have a prototype. If you design websites, have a prototype. Have something to show to the customer. Both science and art have really proved that and showed that it's very easy to convert a customer whom you're trying to sell to when you have the sample at hand, rather than that customer you're trying to just sell with words. So every time you're having the sample, it will become very easy for the customer. The customer will feel the quality of the good you're trying to sell to them. And it will also become very easy for the customer or for you to close the sale there and then, other than postponing it to tomorrow. So always have a sample every time you're moving. Extra technique for the people that deal in clothes, shoes, that type of merchandise. It's very easy to sell your things if you start categorizing them into limited editions. Over time, I've realized that customers usually prefer goods that are kind of scarce. Once your goods are scarce or they are not easy to get, customers will always prefer those goods to the other goods that are everywhere. This is one of the other reasons why ladies prefer going to downtown to buy their clothes other than going to the uptown shops, because they don't want to wake up one morning putting on a dress while walking on the street, they find another person putting on such a dress. So if you do limited editions, it creates a feeling of scarcity. The customer gets to think that this thing is unique, and that is what customers usually want. So once you make your goods scarce and limited editions in one way or another, it will help you raise sales, because the next time you put up a limited edition, customers will rush to buy while the offer still lasts, or while the limited edition offer still lasts. So that is a technique for people who deal in clothes, shoes, and that type of merchandise. Limited editions will also work for you, as I've tried it and it has worked for me. As we've shared today, before selling, make sure you are credible. Build trust with the customer, build a relationship with the customer, and always have a sample at hand. These techniques I've shared with you have worked for me over the time. I've tried all of them, and trust me, they have lifted me from zero level to some level. So please try those things out, and you'll be letting me know how your selling game has improved over the time. Please share more and more techniques in the comment section below about the techniques I can also apply in selling, so that we can start maximizing our sales each and every day. If you like the video, please share the video. Share it as much as you can. Let's help entrepreneurs and businessmen sell their products and overcome this challenge of selling. Hit the notification bell to always receive notifications about the video, and subscribe to our YouTube channel if you've not yet subscribed. I remain Mayor. Salute.